Good afternoon, Mr. President. You're live on Diamond TV News on the go. Would you be able to give us a reaction to what you know transpired in the arrest of Mr. Kambwili's wife, Caro, as well as daughter Chanda? And of course, later on, you can also give us you know a reaction towards what transpired.
I think it's a sad development from many angles. First, court. Court is a public place. And when the accused or remandees, whatever you want to call them, are brought to court, the law allows relatives, friends to be in attendance in court. But the fact that's going on at this gate there, where people are restrained from coming into court, obviously within the guidelines, that's why you see me with the mask. I'm meeting the health guide. We are meeting the health guide. She met the health guide. There should have never been scaffolding at the entrance point. I can confirm the scaffolding going on because I can say I was briefly detained by the way. It's a detention. So that's problem number one. There must be free flow of people into and outside when there's business to be court. Like she has business to be court. I have business to be court. Even you media have business to be court. That's the best issue. Second issue is important. I think the police did not act professionally to manhandle the wife of a person in prison. How does anyone normally expect a wife to behave? She's coming here, attending court, hearing for her husband, she's being harassed. Naturally, she's already in a mood as a human being, that needs compassion, not pushing, shoving, not attacking her. I understand, I haven't seen her. She's been good, she's been brutalized by the police. What's happening? What's happening in the police command? What's happening with those in charge of the police? Those who believe they're in charge of this country. This is lawlessness in itself to manhandle Mrs. Kambwili and the daughter, I guess. It's lawless. Remember, there's a perception in our country that lawlessness means it. Only those outside government can be lawless. Now you have the state, you have the government, you have the PM acting in a lawless manner. That's the second point I make. The third point I make, this is yet another demonstration of the absence of the rule of law. No respect for the laws that apply around court issues. No respect for human rights, because it's the right for us to be here. It's her right to be here. This is unacceptable. She must be released, but the police should be ashamed of taking her into cells. Remember, imagine the trauma that she's going through. The husband is already in prison. Where is the human face of this leadership of the PM? It was never there. It lied, the PM lied that there were people's government. They never went. They lied. And that's, you know, the English say the test of the pudding is in the eating. We can see that they are lawless, they don't respect human rights. They need to release the lady now. It's only the sensible thing. There are too many criminals out there. In our trip to Kasama and way back, we were attacked in Pika by the PF criminals. In full view of the police, they should arrest us, not her. In Lavshimanda, we were attacked. Full view, including gunshots fired at us. Those who committed are in their homes. Mrs. Kambwili is in detention. This is jungle law. It happens in Serenje. Those are the ones that need to be in detention, not her.
On your human standpoint, would a normal and professional police manhandle the most stripped of the woman that culturally is a woman?
No. This is yet another problem. Where we have the police taken over by PF cadres and thugs. PF thugs are wearing police uniforms. we ask Kanganje to clean up his police. They must clean up the police. No professional policeman can act in the manner I am told you are telling me that they acted against Mrs. Kabuye. You went for training. Those of us who went for some military training, part of the training is about professionalism. It's about discipline yourself. If you want to discipline others, you must be disciplined. That conduct demonstrates lack of discipline by those police officers. But the issue, the rot lies in the fact that you have PF cadres who are wearing police uniforms. Our police uniform, Mrs. Kambwiri's police uniform, your police uniform. Therein lies the problem. Therein lies why we have no rule of law in this country. Therein lies the problem. And the solution here, fellow citizens, is nothing other than effecting a change of government in 2021. Imagine living like this for another 5 years plus. How shall we live as a country? How shall we survive? We should all work together to manaka. Now there's only two sides, the bad, the ugly, the corrupt, the surrogates, the PF, and all the mankoles on that side. And on the other side is the good, is the people of Zambia, where we should all be. There's no middle ground. I ask anybody who is undecided now, take a decision. You are with the people or you are against the people, together with PF. That's all. Get your national registration cards now. Get your voters' cards. Turn out to vote in large numbers and protect. So we can change this country, bring decency, bring rule of law, bring order, bring back a professional police and the civil service, and all of us will behave correctly. Thank you.
But in the legal palace, they say justice denied. You came here, obviously, awaiting for, you know, hearing of the door application, but that has not been done. How does this make you feel?
This is the breakdown of the rule of law I've talked about. You have already said justice denied, justice delayed. But especially when it's awfully and deliberately delayed, orchestrated by those who are supposed to dispense justice timely, fairly, they are the ones orchestrating delays. They are tired. Look at the way they appear. Look at the way they walk. Look at the way they talk. You can tell that these guys are tired. The situation is out of control. The country has collapsed. Everything has collapsed. Change is in the air. Change is written on that wall. You can see on that wall, on that wall. It's up to us to work together to effect it. Thank you.
Thank you so much for having us in that story. I have it been asked to my app here at the Osaka
Okay.